Hey, what's going on? I'm Dr. Boyce Watkins from Your Black World and the Black Business School. And today I want to talk a little bit about drama and how our addiction to drama can be a dream killer and keep us from accomplishing our goals and keep us from being focused. And the person that I get the pleasure of talking about this topic with today is Ms. Danielle Pierce from FinallyQueenTV.com. How are you doing today, Danielle?
I'm doing awesome. How are you doing, Dr. Boyce?
I'm doing really well, really well. And you and I were just kind of talking about that, you know, before we went live, drama, just people that seem to always have drama going on and how that can get in the way of being able to accomplish goals. You know, like I got a friend that I can think of who is super talented, super capable. You know, he could do pretty much whatever he wants. But every time I talk to him, there is something going on. It's always, there's always a story. There's always, I would be doing this, but my cousin came over and he bought the baby and then the car broke down and then the dog died and then the rat came along and ate the kitten. And, you know, like there's always a crazy story. And what happens is, you know, I don't think he understands why his life isn't moving forward. You know, whereas I kind of, from the outside, I kind of see a lot of this drama kind of affecting that. Have you ever seen that up close yourself?
I have. So I can't say in my circle of friends at this present stage, but I have in the past, but I do have a couple of family members that come to mind where you give them, they literally always have something going on. They always have a reason why, like I present a solution to something and they have 15 reasons why that solution will not work before they even try it. And they're pretty young too. I'm talking about like 20 something years old. And every time I say, oh, why don't you do this? Oh, well, no, I can't do that. I can't get to work. I can't get a ride. There's no transportation in this area. Uber doesn't work out here. It's just always a long list of reasons why that thing can't be done. So yeah, I'm familiar with that.
Okay. So everybody watching on Instagram, tell me if you know what we're talking about, you know, just people that have drama and drama keeps them moving forward. And some of you may be in that category. I don't think it's a matter of dissing anybody, right? Because I know that I've had drama. I'm sure you've had drama, you know, and I don't think drama is just a black thing. Although I think black people, we have a heightened level of drama because being black is a little bit of a roller coaster ride sometimes.
It is.
At least in America, you got some issues that maybe, you know, the average white person doesn't have to deal with. How do you process drama? Like when you are faced with drama in the middle of you trying to handle your business or trying to go make your money or whatever, because you're a successful businesswoman, how do you process drama yourself and still remain focused?
So the way I process it is I get shit done that I need to get done, period. So I don't dwell in it. I don't go trying to solve everything. I don't go trying to be master of the universe. I still focus on what I need to get done. Because that's just what I need to get done. The drama doesn't, it's not going to help me. And again, this is relatively new. I can't say that. I actually pretty much have always been that way. I'm not the real, like, getting into the mess. I'll give you an example. I have a lot of my potential clients will inbox me or email me, and they lead off with drama. And a lot of it starts with, I'm a single mom, you know, X, Y, Z. Like, they identify, like, that's the very first thing that'll come out of their mouths is, I'm a single mom, or I have all this going on. And I get it, but I think to myself, and sometimes I've said this, like, are we exchanging who has it harder? Because, you know, quiet as it's kept, you know, I could go through a long list of things, too. I got family in jail. I got my mother who's sick, who had a stroke. I have people who died. I've had all IRS tax issues. Like, I mean, are we exchanging drama? Is that what we're doing here? So I have my own set of issues, too. But I'm just not out, you know, promoting it into the world, trying to get something in exchange for that.
Well, you know, I'll tell you what. And by the way, I'm talking to Danielle Pierce. Danielle's website is economicelevation.com. She teaches financial literacy, things like that, as well as foreclosures and anything you want to know financial. It's economicelevation.com. And please hit the thumbs up button if you're watching, because we're talking about drama and how drama can get in the way of your ability to get things done, but also how to deal with that. You know, I'll tell you this. When I look at, not just in my own life, because we've all been wrapped up in drama. We've all had situations where drama kept us from doing something important that we needed to do, myself included. I know that what impacted me, though, was when the drama's all said and done and you're emotionally drained and you still didn't accomplish your goal and you didn't get what you were looking for. You feel pissed, you know? you feel angry. I know I would be just mad at myself. Like, why did you let yourself get caught up in this stupidity? What was it that you got from that? I think sometimes we get something emotional from that, like feeling some of us almost, it almost seems like sometimes we can get an addiction to the drama because yeah, sometimes like that's the way it's supposed to be. And maybe that comes from childhood. Do you think that comes from childhood?
Yeah, I think it comes from, if your whole life has been a certain way, it's always been, you know, situation after situation after situation, it's always been traumatic and you've never experienced anything else. You don't know that what you, your whole childhood and your whole life is abnormal. You don't know that that's dysfunctional. And so you create it because that's what you've always known. And you'll continue to create it over and over and over again until you figure out that, okay, something's not working and I'm the common denominator. So maybe I should start looking at myself.
Yeah, you know, and I think that's an important point, right? That's what one thing we have to accept is that in our lives, in every situation, the only person who's always there is you. The person whose decisions have the greatest impact in what happens in your life is you, right? So if your life is what you want it to be, then you can give yourself credit, pat yourself on the back. But if your life isn't what you want it to be, you got to kind of analyze and look at yourself, you know? Now, one thing I've noticed, Danielle, is that when I see people that fall into drama, like I have another friend I'm thinking about where she's always in the middle of drama. And, you know, every time I talk to her, I'll be like, so how you doing? And she'll say, oh, I'm okay. I'm all right. And I'll be like, what's going on now? And she'll be like, oh, I had to go. My cousin got locked up. I had to go and bail my cousin out. And then my sister called me in the middle of the night because something happened with her boyfriend. And then I had to go take my best friend's son because blah, 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 blah. Like, she'll just have a million stories. And I remember telling her, I said, yeah, you're Captain Save-A-Ho. That's what you are. You know, and I said, because you're saving everybody. You're saving all these hoes in your life, male and female. Every hoe can apply, right? And I'm just being silly. But the point is that you know, like that Captain Save-A-Ho mentality, and I'm going to stop calling it that because I know it sounds ratchet. But that idea that I got to save everybody, I'm carrying the weight of the world on my shoulders. Maybe you're the only one in the family who's got a little bit of money, so you feel like you got to pay for everything. You're the only one who's got a little bit of education, so you got to solve every problem. You're the only one who has it together, so everybody who doesn't have it together, they call you when there's an issue. That becomes tough. I mean, have you seen that, Danielle?
But to be honest, Dr. Boyce, that's been my life for a very long time. So I take that back. I have had an addiction to drama, and it's been just what you said. Being Captain Save-A-Ho, trying to be, I call it being master of the universe. So, and you get something from that though. Like, it's easy to blame other people and say, oh, y'all always pulling at me, asking for money, asking for help, asking me to, you know, read this and do this and do that. But the reality is that, you know, when we do that, like, I had to accept responsibility for the fact that I opened that door and I actually was kind of thriving on that. Maybe feeling needed, maybe feeling like, you know, people couldn't get their shit together without me, when the fact of the matter is, people will be just fine. People will be just fine without me. Like, they'll figure this shit out, and they have, and if they don't, they'll still be okay either way. There's a high that people in that do that get from that, and they don't necessarily like to admit. It's painful to admit it. I know it was for me. I was just like, damn, is that true? I was like, yeah, that has been true.
Wow. Well, you know, I know you have a busy schedule and I'm not going to take up much of your time, but I wanted to have that quick conversation. And what I'll do is I'll kind of lay out a couple of thoughts I have in terms of, because it's not a matter of talking about it, but it's a matter of finding solutions. And I know a couple of solutions that really worked for me was one, learning how to say no. It was really hard for me to say no. You know, I what would happen is I would absorb other people's emotional turmoil. So even if my life was going well, things were going good for me, if things were not going good for you, I would internalize, you know, your agony. And I would start to feel like your problems were my problems. And I learned that that's a heavy emotional burden to carry. I'm not carrying it no more. So now I do just, you know, when people start bringing me drama, I just cut it off. I shut it down. Or I disconnect, you know, force myself to do that because I'm not going to carry all that around with me. I think the other thing too is in terms of creating and dealing with our own drama in our lives, I believe there's something to be said about, you know, just refusing to allow drama to take more than a certain amount of space in your psyche. You know, like there are grown ass people who just get shit done. People who say, yeah, I know that, you know, the milk got spilled on the kitchen floor and so-and-so wants to cuss me out and blah, blah, blah is mad down the street. But I got to go handle this business because I got to get the bills paid, right? So all of that stuff is getting wiped off the table because I need the table to be clear so I can focus on being a grown-up. What are your thoughts on that?
I think that's it exactly. That's what I've had to learn to do. I had to, well, for me, I had to learn how to, it was an ego check. It was a realization that, you know what, people don't need you as much as you think that they do, or as much as they think that they do. And then also when people come at you like that, it leads to something else. So you feel like you're helping. And what happens is people will start to then resent you for helping them. So then it's just like this huge like clusterfuck of just drama and BS, and you really, it's difficult to get out of. So yeah, I agree with that 100%.
All right. So I don't know if anybody else has any thoughts on this, but we just wanted to address this issue really quick because I thought it was just something worth talking about. Danielle Pierce, in case you guys want to follow her, her website is economicelevation.com. She teaches, what is it, foreclosures or how to make money from foreclosures. What else do you teach?
Yes, tax lien investing and how to make money from foreclosures. And there's also like a basic business and marketing package for people who are just brand new to starting a business.
Okay. All right. So feel free to go to economicelevation.com. And I'm Dr. Boyce Watkins. Make sure you hit the thumbs up button, the subscribe button before you go. And I want to say thank you again, Danielle, for helping us have a great drama-free morning conversation. And I hope that this helped everybody who's watching. I see some of you out watching on Instagram, which is The Real Boyce Watkins. So you guys have a good day. So cut the drama out, handle your business. Go get what's yours, and then everything else will work itself out, and you can come back and chip in a little bit, but don't let that drama overwhelm your life, because your life is short, all right? So take care, everybody. You guys have a good day. Thank you, Danielle. It was very good talking to you.
All right, bye-bye.
All right, bye-bye.